Whether you've seen shifting of the fat pads, loss of fat from devices, or loss of fat from aging, this is your video. Are you seeing facial fat loss? Hollowing of the temples? Maybe under eye bags with a line of demarcation under the eye showing kind of like a hollowness? Maybe an extra cheek? We call a malar fat pad. Lines demarcating what seems to be fat in the face, as opposed to the young who were confluent and full, and that gives a youthful look. You see, fat is good in the face. Can be bad, but it can be great. Also, the edge of the mouth. Down here, we have fat loss, the preauricular area, and then we have the sag down here. If you're seeing some of these changes, this video is for you. I'm going to take you through why it occurs, preventive measures, really key. What are some of the nutritional things that are causing it that you can change? Also, what are some treatments? If you need a little bit more, some all natural or some synthetic injections. So there's something for everyone, but you need to understand why it's occurring, at least prevent it, and do some things at home to bring that fat back in the areas you want. Let's dive in, get into this one. If you're getting value from my videos, click the like button, definitely subscribe, because you know there's much more coming. Number one is, and I'm gonna put these two together, age and sun. Basically, think of loss of collagen in the building blocks and the structure and support of your skin and face. Age, of course, the machinery just slows down. You have increasing factors in the body like MMPs, matrix metalloproteins, a lot of study on these, and different collagen kind of killing factors that are in your body that ramp up, and you don't make as much collagen, therefore, as you break down. Sun, of course, as we know, kills collagen, which is why the under eye is one of the first areas to show it, because a lot of people don't put what? Sunscreen under the eye. The other area you're gonna see it, especially if people are in shape or of correct body weight, body mass index, is preauricular and edge of the mouth. Those are your first two or three areas. So age and sun, and I put them a little bit together. Number two, and I did a whole video on this, what do people do at 40? They don't really want injections. The majority of people don't want those things, but they go get a heating device, an Ulthera, a Hi-Fu, radio frequency, thermage, all those treatments. And for the majority of people, what they're seeing that they think is hollowing is tightening of the skin. So as the skin tightens, it's perceived that there's loss of fat. However, the devices themselves can cause fat loss. You need to know who's doing your treatment and what device is being used. And when you watch my whole video on this device ruined my face, you'll see what I mean by that. So devices are number two. Number three, and I have friends like this, the exercisers. Now, I'm a big sport guy, exercise a lot. I think it's the best drug on earth for your serotonin, for your body, for your hormones, testosterone, everything. However, it's the intense exercisers. Oh, what you do today? Ah, I ran to the next city and back. You know, I ran 25 miles today. Oh, I biked 1,000 miles today. Oh, really? We're not gazelles. We're not like cars. We're not meant to go those distances. As an aside, you work in an orthopedic clinic, everyone coming in for knee replacements are runners, people hard on their knees, okay? Some people can do it, but the problem is you get facial wasting. And I tell my friends, I'm like, you look like you're 100. They do, but there's a double factor. What happens when you run and you cycle? You're in the sun. I don't know how they do it. These people running around 3 o'clock, it's 90 degrees, and they're cruising around. It's a double hit. They're going to look way older. And sunscreen only protects against 50% of the sun, even an SPF 50 within an hour or two. So that's not the whole answer. And you can't cover your whole body, but you should probably. So high intensity exercise, I'll leave it at that. Number four, poor nutrition. And this is plaguing our society. High processed foods, high sugars, very high carbohydrates. A lot of people can't afford to eat organic, non-GMO, non-processed foods. The lineup at McDonald's is bigger than the lineup at Safeway or your grocery stores. And Whole Foods, Whole Paycheck, It's true. It costs a lot of money. I eat a lot of plant-based, and I walk out of there, everything's $100, $200, and I'm buying for myself. It's expensive. So nutrition plays a role, and particularly, even if you think you're eating well, we're not eating real foods or fruits. What do you do about it? Number one, sun prevention, nutrition. I have many videos on nutrition. Those are easy things, low-lying fruit, as they say, things you can do and you should do. Number two, I talked about protein and collagen. Collagen powder works. I have whole videos, I'll put a link here and then below, on my videos on collagen powder, the studies, even tracking the molecules into the body. So many people don't think the collagen absorbs, but here's a study that looked at the absorption. And if we go to the discussion, the study demonstrated a significant amount of peptide was absorbed and entered the portal vein when using these peptides. It goes on to say that this is the first report and analysis of these smaller peptides being transported across the intestinal wall. So we know now that there is absorption. More and more data on collagen powder, but here's what you do. Forget what I say, forget all the studies, are they sponsored or not. Go read the comments below my videos on collagen powder, see what people are saying. I don't delete any comments unless they're untoward, meaning there's poor words in there, or if they're hurtful to other people. I don't mind being hurt, I'm used to that. You're on these channels, I'm on social media, hit me all you want, I don't care. But you can't treat other people poorly. So I leave all the comments up, so you'll see positive and negative, but you'll see hair, nails, joints, skin, in that order. People love collagen powders, and I'm on them. I think everyone should be on them. I have 10,000 patients in my database. My patients are on them. So very important. Next, we're going to massage and skin cream. Okay, this stuff works. So fat wants to grow back in your face. Fat wants to regenerate, just that our machinery is decreased. So by taking your favorite cream, especially your moisturizer. A moisturizer, people are like, don't spend a lot of money on moisturizer, and you might not have to, but if you get a great high organic content moisturizer, of course, I like grapeseed oil, neem seed oil, jojoba seed or jojoba oil, willow bark extract, vitamin E, and massaging, because what does massaging do? Increases blood flow. When people would just massage their face with the placebo, so there'd be the active skincare here, and your placebo here. The placebo group did pretty darn well because they're massaging. So take your moisturizer. I like, of course, I have an ultra moisture. You might have the one that you like. One with ceramides, fats, lipids, sunflower, safflower oil, all the ingredients I mentioned. Massage a couple times a day. That certainly helps increase blood flow, and I think that helps a lot. So I am a fan. People say, well, you don't like facial massage. Not to lift your face, but to help improve your fat, improve circulation. The studies show that. Okay, so you want to go next level, but you want all natural? Easy now. Blood draw, platelet-rich fibrin. It's not PRP. PRP's by the wayside. Platelet-rich fibrin, no additives. Draw your blood, spin it down, inject it back. It forms a fibrin clot. You get slow release of growth factors. That works amazingly well. And I think part of it, a lot of what we're seeing is it's action on the fat pads. I think we're rejuvenating fat pads. I've done thousands of under eyes with it. And I think that's what we're seeing. The dentists use this for a long time for bone and bone growth. And they have great radiological studies. And they've shown me putting teeth into jaws that don't have a lot of bone is hard. They use the PRF first. And we see appear to be growing bone. Your stem cells can grow whatever they're around. And I have videos on these. I don't want to go into depth, but I have in-depth videos on all the different growth factors we're looking at and what they're doing. But I think it really helps the fat, very much so. If you want next level from there, and less you're needing this, of course, I mentioned HIV lipoatrophy was the first way I used Sculptor for patients who were losing fat in their face. And we learned a lot from Sculptor. And that was 2004 in this country. 2009, it was approved for aesthetics. So we learned a lot from 2004 to 2009 about the product, but it absolutely volumizes and tightens the skin. But you see, you have so many options. What do you do? Let me know in the comments below. I put a complete playlist up here on biostimulators and down here on things you can do at home. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.